मैम रिकॉर्डिंग इज स्टार्टेड, वी कैन स्टार्ट नाउ।
श्योर, यू कैन शेयर द स्क्रीन. ओके, सो यस, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. गुड इवनिंग ट्विंकल मैम.
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग. सो यस, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेशन. ओके, सो वट एवर वी हैव लर्न्ड सो फार, ओके, विल जस्ट डिस्कस दैट फर्स्ट फॉर फर्स्ट 5 to 7 minutes, देन विल स्टार्ट विद आवर टुडेज एजेंडा. इज दैट ओके ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस मैम।
श्योर. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. ओके, सो दीज आर द, या जस्ट प्रीवियस वन मैम. मैम प्रीवियस स्लाइड. स्नेहल मैम.
स्नेहल मैम प्रीवियस स्लाइड शो कर दो।
शायद नेटवर्क इशू हो रहा है.
यस मैम आई हैव शेयर्ड, आई थिंक इट्स नॉट विजिबल टू यू बट आई एम चेंजिंग।
यू कैन रीशेयर, यू कैन स्टॉप शेयरिंग एंड देन स्टार्ट.
यस ओके
यस यस
ओके ओके
या, देयर वुड बी एनी टेक्निकल ग्लिच आई बिलीव, नो प्रॉब्लम. सॉरी फॉर द इनकन्वीनियंस एवरीवन, जस्ट गिव अस 2 to 3 minutes, विल स्टार्ट ऑफ. ओके. Okay, so as you can see, we have already discussed. This is the agenda of the training overall. Okay, so this is for week one, and we have completed introduction to HRM yesterday only, and now today we will be covering HR basics and history of human resource management. Okay. Okay.
ओके मैम, ओके
Yes.
मैम।
So yes, we have discussed already, right? What is human resource management? Just quickly, any one of you, just like whatever you feel, just give the answer. We have already discussed it yesterday, right?
यस मैम।
Yes. Yeah. You can go.
सॉरी मैम, व्हाट डिड यू आस्क?
I am asking that we have already discussed, right? What is human resource management? So whatever you have remembered, you can share with us.
ओके मैम, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट इज लाइक अ मीडिएटर ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट इज बिटवीन द सुपर अथॉरिटी एंड द एम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड एम्प्लॉयज, एंड इट हेल्प्स टू क्रिएट अ सेफ एनवायरनमेंट लाइक सेफ्टी फॉर द एम्प्लॉयज, एंड ऑल्सो हेल्प्स टू मैनेज द टास्क दैट आर गिवन बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इट परफॉर्म फंक्शंस लाइक पेरोल्स, सिक्योरिटी, वेजेस, सैलरी and etc. etc. and it is like the main thing for an organization that takes care of everything.
Yes, absolutely. Just whatever you have said, ma'am, Swarna ma'am, it is correct. Just remember the one word, which is like human resource management is the systematic process of developing, maintaining, and retaining employee. Okay, just remember these words.
ओके मैम.
Sure, all of you agreed?
यस मैम,
Okay.
ओके मैम,
Yes.
ओके मैम।
Yes, so here you can see we have already discussed it's related to hiring, motivating, maintaining, and related to most importantly,
ऑर्गेनाइजेशन,
yes, employee in the organization, people in an organization. Okay, now, yes, these all we have discussed yesterday. Just one by one, just take the point and just tell me what you have understood. First point, ma'am, anyone, any ma'am? ज्योति मैम, स्वर्णा मैम, दिव्या मैम, मानसा मैम, वर्तिनी मैम, वी हैव डिस्कस इट, right?
Ma'am, the first point is just like I said that it manages the functions and principles. Principles are regarding to the rules that an organization have and that the employees have to follow, like their policies, company's policies, and application of management functions. Like the company that has its functions, like what they are doing, what is the content of the job, everything comes under that. So it involves everything, the orientation, and includes everything for the employees and the company both.
Yes, correct, correct. Okay, other 3 points. Anyone just want to share the thoughts, whatever you have?
Ma'am, the second point, decision relating to employees must be integrated. So it means decision plays major role in hiring a candidate, perfect candidate. So it means that, in simple view, is it correct, ma'am?
Yes, correct, absolutely. Okay, and the other points? Okay, we can simply say that human resource involves application of management functions, right? It helps to make the decisions and how you can apply those decisions in an organization in an effective way, and how you are helping by taking those decisions to improve that organization and achieve that organization goal. It's very important, and it's a main role of human resource management, correct? Okay, now
Yes, ma'am.
scope of human resource, it's similar to the like nature also. So just any 2 points anybody can discuss or anybody can just say any two. There are 9 points, right? Scope of HRM.
Ma'am, motivation, welfare, health, and safety is just like HR, human resource management, make sure that their employees be motivated for the task that they are giving
Sure.
them, and they make sure that their job safety should be there, their job satisfaction should be there. Safety is according to, like you have said, like if someone is doing an overtime and woman, so she should be taken care of her safety. And the training and development, the fifth one, is when the new employees get in the organization, so they make sure that they get the proper training, like how they need to do the task, and there should be some development in their personality, in their work. So it's the,
Yeah.
it's that HRM do.
Correct. Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. So I think it's clear with all of you, right? So we can
Yes,
move
ma'am.
ahead with our next slide. So objectives, any 1 point, any one objective anyone can share? Quickly, whatever you remember. These all are discussed yesterday, right? Any organizational objectives? Anything? Don't feel nervous, guys.
Ma'am, organizational objectives are just like the training, the hiring, recruitment, talent and management, all that includes in it, and the personal objectives, the wages, salary, all of that.
Okay, fine. Yeah.
Personal satisfaction of the employees, personal objective
Yes,
belongs to.
that is also correct. Fine.
Okay.
So yes, next slide. Functions. Okay, let me just ask you about talent management, right? Orientation, induction, we have discussed yesterday. So anyone quickly just tell me the difference between induction and orientation. Or not the difference, just tell me what are those. Guys, please cooperate with us. Right?
Ma'am, total rewards is like just as it is written, compensation, incentives, benefits. It helps to keep the employee motivated in their work so that they come to organization daily and do their work.
Okay.
Compensation,
Swarna ma'am,
incentives and benefits are like the add up.
yes, you are saying correct, but I asked what is the difference between induction and orientation? That's what I asked. We discussed it yesterday.
Ma'am, according to me, I think I'm not much clear, but I think orientation is about the setup that you have in the organization, and you make make them aware about that setup of your organization. And induction is just I think giving them the knowledge about their work, that what they have to do. I'm not sure.
Yes, correct. So induction is a short-term event. It's basically when the employee joins for the first day, it has scheduled for them to, you know, making them understood about their roles and all. Okay. And orientation is the process to familiarize new hires, like with the company policies, guidelines. Okay. Correct. So it's all about compliance and getting new hires up to speed on process, paperwork, and the company's general administrative structures. So it's basically about the company structure and all. Okay, understand? Now I think it's clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so fine. Next slide. Okay, this is very simple and just one person. I just wanted to hear from Jyoti, ma'am. What do you understand, ma'am? Role of HRM? Quickly just sum up these three words and just give me one sentence answer. In your own
understand. Ma'am, I'm not intern.
Okay. Sorry. Fine. Okay. Divya, ma'am?
Ma'am, shall I?
Yeah, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. The role of the HRM is planning and develop. Planning is plays an important role, ma'am. In HRM, actually, in organization, planning and development and administrative. These three are main things for the HR, ma'am, in organization. That's it, ma'am.
Okay. Anyone wants to try? Fine. So, role of HRM is basically planning, okay, and executing those plans, developing those plans, and how they administer all the things in an organization to manage those employees. Correct? So, let's start with today's topics. Okay. We'll discuss HR basics. We'll discuss recruitment and selection, performance management, learning development, succession planning, compensation management, human resource information system, HR data, and HR analytics. Okay. So, yes, recruitment and selection. What do you guys understand about recruitment and selection? Anybody, any idea?
Hiring the employees in an interview.
Okay, this is selection and recruitment.
Recruitment, ma'am.
Okay, so what is a selection?
Final selection is final interview. HR round is there, ma'am, in an interview. That is final selection of the employee.
Okay. Point of time, you are correct, but not properly. Okay.
Selection is choosing a perfect candidate based on the performance, ma'am, in the final session.
Okay,
that is called selection, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, so let me just give you the basic idea of recruitment and selection, because afterwards you guys will be discussing, like we will be discussing, and you guys will be getting understanding of this in a detailed manner. Okay, so recruitment, it basically involves attracting and obtaining as many applicants as possible for the applicant, like eligible job seekers. Okay. Correct,
okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. And like we can say that recruitment is the process of finding and attracting capable applicants for employment. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And selection? Yes. So selection is the process of picking individuals, okay, out of the pool of job applicants. Okay, right. If we want to select for two people, we'll be getting thousands of applicants, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. From them, we have to choose, as an HR, we have to choose the proper correct people for that correct role, like whatever job role is open, right? For that role, who is the most suitable person that is related to selection? Okay, and yes, are you guys getting it? So selection
yes,
is choosing the candidates who is the best suited from the pool of interested candidates. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now next slide. Yes, performance management. Anyone have any idea about this word, performance management? What does it do in an organization? Anything?
We have, ma'am, may I?
Yes, sure.
Ma'am,
sure.
We have to see the performance of the candidates, whether they are performing well or not.
Mm-hmm.
And if they are not performing well, we have to give them warning.
Okay, yes, but it's not all the time warning. Okay, so let me just correct you. A employee has set a goal. Okay, we suppose their employer and employee, they have seated and they have set a goal. Okay, which goal? The goal is definitely should be aligning with the organizational goal and that employee's personal goal. Okay, both should be aligned with each other. And how that employee is performing to achieve that goal, okay, how that the day-by-day work is progressing or there is any progress or no progress, how the employee is, giving the correct time, how they should, that the employee should work, or how the employee should, go ahead with the learnings and all for achieving those goals, it's related to performance management. Okay, where as an HR or as an HR manager, we have to plan their goals. Okay, we have to set their individual, like we have to consider their individual goals, right? And that should be aligning with the organizational goals. Correct? And it should be a continuous process. It's not like after 6 months or 1 year, we will be, sitting and just checking with each other. No, it has been, discarded from the, we used to do it. Okay, but now it's a continuous process, day by day discussion. And where bosses or managers, they should behave like a mentor, not like a boss. Okay, so that the employees share their thoughts process, share their goals. Okay, it would be easier to make them understood about our goal, our organization goal. And as a manager, it is very important to understand their goals as well. Correct? So the feedback and the process, everything, check-in meetings and all, everything should be very, in a regular basis. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So any understanding in performance management?
It's cleared, ma'am.
Okay. So it is, yes. So now training and development, correct? So yes, training and development, I think we have discussed in a certain point yesterday, training and development. So just, I just wanted to hear from you guys about this point, training and development. And it's written already, right? So you can just explain in your own word. Anyone?
Ma'am, training is the process of enhancing the knowledge and skill of an employee required for a particular job. HR should train the employees who are selected for the particular role in the organization.
Okay.
HR should be a train up, ma'am, in training.
Okay. Correct.
For the particular role, for particular job, that should be suitable for that. That means
okay,
HR should be.
Yes. Okay. Just let me tell you. Basically, training refers to a systematic setup. Okay, where employees are instructed and taught matters for what the skills required for the particular job they have hired for. correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, that's simple, in simple word, that is training. And development, whereas development refers to the overall holistic and educational growth and maturity of people in managerial positions. So the process of development is in, you know, relations of insights, attitudes, adaptability, leadership, and human relations. Are you getting it? What is
Yes,
the difference
ma'am.
between training and development? I think it's clear with everyone.
All clear, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, Manasa ma'am. Akanksha ma'am, Divya ma'am, Vartini ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Clear, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, clear.
Yes, ma'am.
So it's okay, fine. So now it's succession planning. See, succession planning is basically, it is also a systematic process where we recognize and create, you know, creating future leaders who are able to take that position of that old ones, if like when they leave that organization. Correct. When somebody leaves the organization, we need somebody, right? We need someone to replace for that place. It's basically, we can see for the CHRO, CEO role, we don't hire them as in like normal, we don't recruit them. Correct. It is a eventual process where the organization, the employees are also eventually promoted to that positions. So it is the that thing where succession planning is a systematic process of recognizing and creating future leaders whom we think that yes, that person can be replaced if that old person replace or the old person leaves or retires. Correct?
Yes, ma'am. We can HR can be yes, ma'am. Shall I tell?
Yes, yes. Don't hesitate.
HR can be pick up the person who are ability, who are have ability and eligibility for the role, ma'am. That means
yes, yes.
Old ones. Yes, ma'am.
Correct, correct. It is the planning, right? We yes, should ma'am. Understand as an HR. We should understand who has that capability to, you know, grab that position. No, all the employees can't do that, right? So we
yes,
need
ma'am.
To understand as an HR. We need to understand their perspectives, their goals as well. Right, as I have said in the performance management, we need to understand their goals also, right? We
yes,
can't,
ma'am.
We cannot promote any employee to that CHRO role or CEO role, correct? Because
yes,
if
ma'am.
Somebody, if we have hired, like we have promoted that person to CHRO CEO role, after that 1 month, that person leaves that organization. Is it suitable hiring? No, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So the planning was lacking at that time. So we should identify who is capable of that role. Are you getting it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we can move ahead. Yes, compensation and management. Benefits. So compensation and benefits, it's basically, we have discussed it yesterday as well. So it's basically the monetary and non-monetary aspects of the like employees, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So anything you guys want to add here in compensation and benefits? Okay. So let me just tell you in a simple word. So it's basically the where salaries and wages, okay, everything is included. And like the earnest allowances, everything. These are all like house rent allowances. These are all non-monetary. And like salary, wages, these are all monetary, like monetary references, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, okay. The next slide. Okay. So like this is new. I think this is new to you guys, right? Human resource information system. Just tell me what you guys are understanding from these four words. Whatever comes in your mind, whatever you can share. There is no wrong answer, okay? You can share. Anything?
Ma'am, the your HR must have all the details about the employees. He should have complete information of the of the employee's previous jobs, and he should have know the employee's background and all.
Yes, absolutely, ma'am. Correct. So basically, you know, human resource information system, it's the most used software in HR, okay, HR domain. So we can see that like it's, you know, it's a system that is used to collect and store data on an organization's employees. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So in most cases, an HRIS, you know, encompasses the basic functionalities needed for end-to-end human resource management. So it's a system for recruitment, performance management, learning development, and more. Okay. So, and the most important thing, it is also known as HRIS software also. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So next slide. So yes, now what you are understanding from this HR data and analytics?
HR should be collecting and analyzing the data of the employees or organization, ma'am.
Okay.
To yes. Improve the organization, yes.
Okay. So, okay. Let me tell you, HR analytics, okay, this is also referred as people analytics. Okay. Just remember those words. Okay. It is also referred as people analytics. Or workforce analytics or talent analytics. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes. So basically, it involves gathering together, analyzing, and reporting HR data. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So it enables your organization to measure the impact of a range of human resource metrics on overall business performance and make decisions based on data. Or in other words, in simple words, we can say HR analytics is a data-driven approach towards human resource management. Okay? Is it
okay,
clear?
Yes, ma'am. All clear, ma'am.
Okay. Till now, whatever we have discussed, everything is clear?
Ma'am, would yes, you please ma'am. Tell this once again, ma'am? HR data
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Just one by one. Which point you were
this
having?
This point only, ma'am. HR
okay. Analytics. HR analytics, right?
Yes, ma'am. This only, ma'am.
Okay. So whatever
ma'am,
I have.
Yes, you ma'am. Can, this only.
Okay. Can you tell me in a simple point, ma'am? In a simple
yes,
okay, sentence, fine. Ma'am. For this definition, ma'am.
See, human resource analytics is also called as people analytics. Workforce analytics or talent analytics. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So basically, it enables. Okay, let me just give a simple answer. It's basically the process of collecting, analyzing all the data of employees. Okay. So we can improve our organization's performance. You know, we can take it up into the another level. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
We can analyze those data. And like, I think you guys have heard about predictive analysis and all. Okay. It's more related to that. So we can analyze those data. We can study those data. Okay. And we can give understanding. We can have a better understanding of the employees who are working with us. Okay. See, most of the companies are, IT companies are, you know, they face attrition problem. Have you heard of that word attrition?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So it's basically people leaves the organization, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Very often.
What's the word attrition? What yes. is the meaning of that word, ma'am?
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Attrition means when people leaves your organization very often. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. It's like there is a reduction in the workforce. We can say like that. Fine. So basically, we have to understand why people leaves our organization, why they are leaving. So for that, we collect data and analyze those data. And we can come up with a solution for that. So it's more related to that, HR analytics, HR data and analytics. Now it's clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
now,
ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, shall I repeat this? Will you please check if it's correct or not?
Yes, sure. Go ahead.
It is a process of collecting and analyzing data in which order to improve an organization workplace performance.
Yes, correct. Okay.
Okay.
So up to this, are you guys having any doubt?
No, ma'am. All clear, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Sure. Now, I think Snehal ma'am will start with the history of HRM. Okay. Please cooperate.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So now we have seen what is HRM, right? So we must know where from this HRM came, like history of HRM. Like we have our, we have school subject history, right? To know that where the human came from, like what was our background, right? So the same like we will see here how HRM came into the organization, okay?
Okay,
so
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Of history of HRM. First, there was industrial revolution era, then trade unions came into existence, then there is scientific management era, then there is consideration of industrial psychology, then human relation era. We'll see one by one, and then we'll see how human resource management era came into existence. Okay. So the first, there was industrial revolution era. So you can see in this picture that there is a owner and there are laborers. And the owners are treating the humans like workers in type of machine. Worker were treated as machine, and there is no satisfaction of workers. Okay. There is no one is there to listen what is the workers feeling. Okay. Because they were treated as the machine, just as a machine. So then employee realized that the owner is exploiting them and they are treating him like the machine. So they started forming the groups. Okay. So they started forming the groups and association to solve these issues. So the forming of association of the laborers is nothing but trade union. So this era came into existence, and the point we're focused here is working hours of the employees, rest periods of the employee, what are the working conditions of the employee, then where whatever wages is given, then type of work, and to reach out to the top management, right? Labor were not able to reach out to the top management, and so they have taken the help of strikes, boycotts, walkouts, physical force or slowdowns, so that top management can listen to them and solve their issues. So this era came into existence, and then scientific management era came into existence. So Frederick Taylor advocated the scientific management. Scientific management means now you will be thinking like there will be formulas and all. It's not like that. The scientific management theory represented by the Taylor. So it was more like scientific selection of person on job. Okay. So before any employee has given any job, like there is no connection between the skills and the job. So Taylor came and he told that the scientific selection must be there for the person. If a person is good in Java language, then he must be given the task of that particular skill only. Okay, so that came into existence in this era. So systematic analysis of job, and then breakdown of job into small mechanical elements, then rearrange into the more efficient combination, so that the productivity of the organization must be increased. Okay. So there should be close cooperation between managers and non-managers, that is employees. So there must be a good relation between employee and employer. Okay. Any doubt until this point? Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am. No doubt, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am. No doubts, ma'am.
Okay. So now previously the employee were treated as a machine. Okay. And then yes, employee raised their voice. And then now they are treated like humans in the scientific management era. Okay. And
okay,
then
ma'am.
Classical organization theory came into existence. So Henry Fayol in 1929, he formed the classical organization theory. Okay. So he found out these six groups. Okay. Technical, that is production, where the actual production of the products is going on. Okay. Then commercial is more like marketing. Okay, so buying, selling and exchange. Then financial department is also there, okay, to handle the monetary and non-monetary benefits. then security of property and persons, then accounting and managerial functions. So Henry Fell gave these departments to work smoothly in the organization. Firstly, previously there is like no departments as such, and everyone is working throughout the company. Okay, so he came up with this industrial departments and activities. So next is human relations era. So now happy worker is productive worker, right? So now the owner is giving importance to the human relation, the physical conditions, the working conditions of the employee, where the employee is comfortable with his working condition, whether he is getting good salary or not. So employer is giving attention to all this point, which is known as human relations era. Right. So human relation is developing here. Employer and employee, there is increasing understanding between these two people. Okay. Right. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So next was behavioral science era. So in this, leadership, motivation, organizational culture, communication, and individual and group dynamics. These points were understood. Okay. To satisfy employees and to motivate them, then there must be an organizational structure to improve the productivity. These five points are very important for the improvement of productivity in the organization, right? So there were only like human relations, like employer and employer, communicating and they're understanding each other. But there must be leadership, motivation also, right, to work. And the employee should free to work. He should feel motivated, and if there is conflict, then communication is one of the important parts. Sorry?
Nothing, ma'am. Going on.
Okay. So these are the points that will improve the productivity. So these came under behavioral science era. Okay. So the next is personal management, where administration work is done in the organization. Okay. Now departments are there. So one of the department was personal management before the human resource management. So personal management gave focus to the strategic function, which will help to achieve the organizational goals. What are the goals? Then there must be a strategy, right? So then human resource management era came into existence. Okay, so which has focused on using strategic function to improve the productivity. So giving employee training, then giving them rewards, then managing their information, okay, giving them promotion. So all the internal functions of human resource management came into existence in this topic. Okay.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Doubt until this point?
No, ma'am. All clear, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
So just tell me shortly from where the human resource management era came to this point. Okay, starting with the
industrial revolution.
Yes, where employer treated as a machine. Then machine,
yes.
Yes, then after. Okay, so then the employees realized that they were exploiting, owner is exploiting them.
Raise their voice.
Yes,
by using then they will be treated as employees.
Yes, human so scientific beings. Management era came into existence, where there yes, were proper management in the employee and employers. Okay, so they were getting their proper jobs and proper conditions.
Yes, okay,
so what was next? After scientific management era, there was classical organizational theory, where Henry Fell came and he said there must be departments where the employees should be divided.
Yes, ma'am. Technical.
Yes, production department.
Production. Yeah. Class.
Financial department.
Financial department, marketing, exchanging and buying and selling, exchanging.
Yes, right. So they were like departmental work, and now employees doing their job according to their department. Okay. Yes, after ma'am. That, then human
relations era.
Yes. Right. So after that, this behavioral science era. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Only if employees having good conditions, will he be able to work if the only conditions are okay and relations are okay? No, right? There must be motivation. There must be
communication and organizational culture.
Yes, right. So it must be there to improve the productivity. And again, after that, there must be a strategic function, okay, to achieve the organizational goal, right? The employees are in the company to achieve the company's goal, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So strategic function point of view is came into existence, and then human resource management came into existence, where we have seen all the steps like recruitment, selection, training and development, giving them rewards, compensation, and having their whole information. Okay. So any doubt in the history of HRM?
No, ma'am. All clear, ma'am.
Okay. So any question about today's session?
No, ma'am.
Okay, everything
according to me, I don't have any questions regarding the today's session, ma'am.
Okay, anyone else? Any question, any doubt about today's points?
No, ma'am.
Okay, everything clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Everything is clear, ma'am.
Everything is clear, ma'am.
Okay. So I'll stop recording and you can ask whatever questions you feel. Okay, yes, Vartini Varsha, ma'am.
Ma'am, sorry, ma'am. My